So first thing in the morning, we come in, find out where we're riding. After we find out where we're riding, go check what we're riding. When I mean check what we're riding, so today I'm riding 8. I'm coming here. You may see in my other videos. Just grab radio. Make sure you got a battery. Make sure you got good battery life. Well, first things first, you toss your gear on the unit. If it's the engine, I mean, you check your SCBA. You check. Make sure you have like the meters and stuff are all being charged and ready to go. On the ambulance, in here, hop in the back. Check, make sure we have everything we had that we need in our gear bag. I'm not gonna go through that right now. That'll be a completely different video. Check the compartments, make sure we have more than enough of what we need. Splints, bandages, tape, gauze, head blocks, straps, body bags, suction devices, air breathing, airway breathing contraptions. This would pretty much what you're checking to make sure is our trash compartments aren't overfilled. We go back, even on the ambulance. Get signed into what we call the EPECR. Stands for EPCR. The driver would check all the outside compartments. Also come and we check out the SCBAs. So yes, we check to make sure we have good sufficient amount of air in the cylinders. We check to make sure that they're working properly, the regulators are working, the alarm devices are working. The driver would check, make sure, you know, tire tread is good, everything's running good as far as the engine compartment. There are no types of issues going on as far as like leaky fluids. Yeah, we're just pretty much recovering all our bases to make sure that we're ready for the call. So after the checkouts, well, after our initial checkout, then we would have line up pretty much go over the plan. And during the lineup, we pretty much are just going over the plan for the day. If there are other apparatus around us that may have some movement that may affect us, give us a higher call volume, or if we're covering a larger area, or if we're going to get like our physicals, or we have some sort of training within the battalion, within the department somewhere. So line up. So after line up, then we do the thorough check as far as like checking everything. If you don't get it done before line up, of course. So after you do your apparatus checks, it's PT time. My favorite time of the day. So depending on the station, just come in and figure out your workout for the day. There is no particular, you know, workout that we're assigned to do. But it would be, if you don't necessarily know what you're doing, I mean, hopefully someone at your station can kind of guide you. If there's like some sort of PT program, I'm sure there's somebody that you can reach out to that can kind of point you in the right direction. Or even Google, YouTube. But also based on the station is the capabilities of your workout. So some stations may not have this contraction, or they may not have a weight, a squat rack, or, you know, like every station is different in our different sizes. But this is one of the newer stations, and it has a pretty good variety of things as far as options. We have a hose pack, which we like to use on our best friend, the Stairmaster. I'm a big fan of like leg workouts. Myself personally, I've always been strong at leg workouts. But I honestly think that the best type of training for a firefighter is cardio circuit. So some cardio mixed in with some functional type movements, training, sandbags, lifting, walking, hose packs, stuff that actually relates to your job. I'm personally a big fan of pull-ups. Got the box jumps, high intensity intervals. I believe are probably the top type of training that firefighters should do. And from time to time, she's definitely do it in partial gear, full gear, so that you can become accustomed to just the weight and the true feel of what it'll feel like when the call goes out and gotta perform. You gotta be able to do work, and gets intense. A lot of intense work for a short period of time. Take a break, go to rehab. Hopefully, you get checked out and you get back in there. So at PT, of course, you get dressed and you eat. Lunchtime. I mean, if you haven't had breakfast, I mean, it's lunchtime around that time. After you eat, train. And like I said, the training depends on what if it's a countywide training going on, if there's something that the battalion chief may want you to do. I mean, your station captain may have some training they particularly may want to cover based on some previous calls, some calls in the area, or like stuff that you may come across some call that was like broadcasted on YouTube or was on the news. We try to just kind of prepare for things that could possibly happen, that have happened. And yeah, we train. And training that is not to say that we'll ever see that particular call again, but there are calls that are very, very similar, and we just want to be ready for any and everything. So that's why PT is vital, just so you're functionally able to perform tasks, and then training so that you're mentally ready to perform the task, like as far as knowledge. So, and that's why I like to meditate, and I like to do yoga, and I like to do PT, because that's my zen. So we train. So after we train, I say it's early evening. Of course, in the midst of all this, there are calls that we'll run. So we try to fit these things in between calls, and sometimes we may not even necessarily get those things done because the calls are most important. We have to answer the call when the call goes out, and though it's not convenient, that's what we signed up for. So yeah, we're here to answer the call. After that, we cook dinner. A lot of times we cook dinner, well, some depending on the station, depending on the shift. We cook dinner. We may go out to get dinner. We bring it back to the station. We eat if we're not getting calls. So a lot of times, well, so I'm a big believer of having something readily available with you on the unit. If it's like a protein bar, some almonds, always have your water. It's always vital to stay hydrated at all times. And like I said, you never know when that call go out and you're actually on a call for hours and hours at a time. It's like tech rescue calls, fire calls. You can be on the call all day. So if there you don't have any calls, you cook dinner, you eat dinner, and then we clean. Gotta have a tidy firehouse. No one wants to live in filth. So yeah, we clean the tables, clean the floors, clean what we used. We may do some additional cleaning, may find, and organize. I mean, we may put some stuff together. Like, I would say most, like a nice tidy firehouse, but that's no guarantee. So we have to organize. We got supplies that we have to organize. We have to make sure the bunk room is clean, where you sleep at is clean. It's pretty much a house outside of your own house, and you have to take care of it as such. And after that, winding down, kind of like what you like to do. Like I said, I like to get on my computer. I like to edit videos, if it's my personal videos, if it's training videos for the county. I like to edit videos. I like learning, so I'll be on YouTube doing some YouTube learning, or going through, like if it's an online course. Never stop learning. It's critical to progression. If you're not progressing, you're regressing. If you're not growing, you're dying. Always learn. And after that, it's bedtime. There's no call, go to bed. There's no call, sleep through the night. And yes, if there's no call, sleep through the night. So yes, in theory, we're on a clock for 24 hours. To answer the call, in reality, there are some days where we don't get many calls. But some days we may not get a call. And then there's some days that get our ass handed to us. There are some days that get our ass handed to us and we're barely in the station at all. For instance, today, I wouldn't say it was that bad, but haven't spent a lot of time in the station today. That's why I'm doing this video versus another video that I plan to do. But long story short, we never know what the day may hold, and it's best just to be flexible and be ready. Do your job. So to answer your question, long story short, is at the firehouse, we do what we would do at home. Take care, we fix things, we organize things, we cook, we clean, we play, we enjoy each other. We watch TV, we nap, we sleep, we eat, we sleep, we poop, we train, we work out. Whatever it is that we would do at home, we do at the firehouse. Get your mind out the gutter.